So, Batman's in the news again.
Really? I hadn't noticed.
Yeah, it's like he's got a big, important movie. Everyone's watching it.
That's true. It happened.
The one thing I've heard is there's really no villain. There's really no Batman. But there's really no villain in this movie. So, let's just do this already, Kyle. Who's the best villain in Batman? I know exactly what everybody just did. Because you saw the title, like, oh, look at that! They didn't pick the Joker! Where's the Joker, Kyle?
We're not doing the Joker.
We're not doing the Joker, because we know that's the one you're going to pick. Two-Face. Quick primer. Harvey Dent. He was the DA of Gotham City, right? It's half of his face burned. In the comics, it's acid. In the movies, it's whatever the hell.
Now,
basically, he goes crazy, because it's a comic. You get burned by acid, you go crazy, because...
Well, it was mind-altering acid.
Every acid is mind-altering. Now he's dual personality. You got your one normal, sane Harvey Dent. And then you got your crazy Two-Face. He's absolutely crazy. He's got a coin, very clear, two-sided coin, but he scratched the side off of one of it. Flips it. He's like, oh, you going to live or die? Am I going to do this or that? Everything's chosen to fade. He's got a perfect gimmick, which works because Batman villains need a good gimmick. He'll flip the coin, and if the coin says, don't do that, he's like, okay, then.
Okay, but the Riddler is a much better villain. Two-Face might be a much more rounded character,
yeah, yeah.
But...
Very well-rounded because of the coin.
but the Riddler is a better villain because he is so diabolical. He tests Bruce Wayne / Batman's mind more than his body. And it's great because it's like the killer from Saw if it was interesting. And also a good movie series. This is what a diabolical fiend this man is. He sets these horrible homicidal traps and these crazy riddles. Mm-hmm. He gives clues to the hero as if to say, I'm smarter than you. There's no way in hell that you're gonna figure this out. I can give you help and you're not gonna figure it out. That's how much better than you I am. And he's saying that to the world's greatest detective.
His riddles, some of them are great, like the ones in those comics that you like, but then you have ones like, what's yellow and right? Oh, a ballpoint banana! Like, you get crazy, and sure, you're gonna say, well, you're just going from the old Batman. No, the Riddler likes, he likes a lot of corny riddles, he likes a lot of simple riddles.
He's doing it for the same, like, you have the Joker who does horrible crazy shit because he thinks it's funny.
Yeah.
You have the Riddler who does horrible and crazy shit because he knows that it'll mess with you. You've had two tries to get Harvey Dent right.
I've had three, actually.
That's true.
I have...
He's Billy D!
That's right. I have, in my wheelhouse of people who have played the Two-Face.
The Two-Face.
I have Aaron Eckhart, who's probably the best. I have Tommy Lee Jones, who makes Aaron Eckhart's performance look
awesome.
Tommy
Lee Jones did a great impression of Jack Nicholson.
Yeah.
I want to give him credit for that.
If we had gone the right way, we would have had Lando Calrissian with half of a face. It would have been great. And the guy who plays Two-Face in the everything else is great, too. The voice. What's his voice? Someone look it up in the comments. You get a prize. It's a wink.
You win the secret prize. The Riddler has pulled off one of the greatest of capers against Batman, and that is Hush.
I thought you were going to spoil Hush.
Hush, I mean, it is the most elaborate thing against Batman.
Yeah.
Tons of villains, all sorts of villains just being hurled at him all at the same time. Is this the ghost of Jason Todd? No, it's Clayface. No, it isn't. Absolutely batshit insane.
Hey, I see what you did.
And then it all turns out, well, who is it? It must be the Joker, right? Only the Joker could do this to Batman. Wrong. False. The Riddler did it all from the beginning. He set the whole thing up.
The nice thing, though, about Two-Face is there is a consistent arc to his character. He starts off as the good guy. He's on par with Batman. He's the White Knight, of course, to the Dark Knight. He went so crazy and warped, but you can still tell this is a good guy. He was a tragic hero. He's an antagonist who you could actually connect with. Riddler's just all weird for the sake of weird.
I'm sorry,
but
you can't connect with the Riddler? I mean, even
well, you can connect in like the, oh, he's fun, but with Two-Face, you're like, huh, that's the dichotomy of man right there. He, good, evil, the yin and the yang, and it's... And then eventually...
Yes, yes, the symbolism is very subtle.
Mm-hmm. And then eventually he gets his face fixed, and he's still kind of crazy. He regains control just enough of his sanity, and he's still fighting it. So for a while, and I'm not sure in current continuity if he's back to riding the banana train to Monkeyville, he at least had an arc. There was an arc to him, whereas the Riddler was just, I'm still riddling.
Chris, you said that the Riddler was not relatable, even in the movies, and Jim Carrey went a little crazy in the second half of the movie, but the first half, he's amazing in this, like, crazed love for Bruce Wayne. Just that one moment where he says, you were supposed to understand. That was amazing! He suddenly, you realize, this is why he hates Batman. Is because Batman is the world's greatest detective! Except he doesn't do much detecting so much as detecting your face with his fist.
I'm done.
I'm just gonna keep talking, because this is important. This is serious.
Serious. So, in Two-Face, he's got one side of his face is burned with acid, and is really bad because it makes him very iconic to look at. You don't even need to see him, what he looks like. You just know one half is the bad guy, one is the good. It's very good to have that for a character.
Nanu, nanu.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to pick other villains.
When you throw the Joker out, it's just really hard to do.
Yes, it
is. I think that's my final word, is those of you who have reservations about The Dark Knight Rises because there's no Joker in it, sorry, Heath Ledger died. Nobody's going to live up to that for a while.
Yeah, we gotta give some time.
And, I mean, you... Those of you who have seen it, you can probably attest that Christopher Nolan did the best he could with the villains that he had at hand. I mean, without the Joker, how do you do Batman, really? I mean, it's order even beyond the law versus chaos way beyond sanity. Like, that's the dichotomy. That and Harvey Dent's got the dichotomy, too.
I really just should have went with Catwoman.